Hey everyone, Marine here for Learn Fun. Today I'm going to show you a different way of how to use your Let's Toast pull tab die set to create a slider mechanism. And just this once, I only used die cuts to create my scene, so let's check out the supplies. So we have Let's Toast pull tab, Easter basket, tiny gift box bunny add-on for the bunny head and cheeks, scalloped tweet box spring house for the small butterflies, Finlay's ABCs to create the word bunny, spring showers for the sun and clouds, acorn house for some ivy and leaves, little flowers for the two flowers and the circles that I used for the bunny's eyes, meadow portrait backdrop for some grass, meadow landscape backdrop for the butterfly and small rock that I used for the bunny's paws. We also have some bunny for my sentiment. And finally, the push here stamp set. So yes, I only used die cuts to create my little spring scene. I don't do that very often, but really it's the same as coloring images, except that you don't have to be careful about going outside the lines. I colored all the elements just as if they were images using my alcohol markers. I applied my lightest color first. Next, I added contrast using a darker color. And then I blended both colors using my lightest marker, and I repeated this until I was happy with the result. Once all my die-cut pieces were colored, I moved on to the background. I cut a slimline panel and took my sponge sugar and Kitsch flamingo oxidings to create a sweet and bright sky and also to match some of the flowers. I applied some sponge sugar first using a cloud stencil, and then I added some Kitsch flamingo to bring depth, and then I came back with my sponge sugar blending tool to blend the colors nicely, and I did this towards the bottom of the panel. So I stopped the clouds and then I created the grass to put my basket on. And to do so, I used shabby shutters and Modlon oxidings. Shabby shutters first, that I applied on the entire blank section towards the clouds. And next, a little bit of Modlon that I blended using my shabby shutters blending tool. And of course, the next step was to add texture to this panel, because you know it, I never leave a background without adding details to it. So I smooshed my pink ink pads onto my glass surface. I added a bit of water and then created a million dots on the paper using a small brush. And in addition to sponge sugar and Kitsch flamingo, I also used some mustard seeds and picked raspberry oxidings to add more splatters on my panel. I let the paper dry and then did the same thing on the grass section using the same green inks as before mixed with water. Next to the fun part. To create the interactive mechanism, I started by cutting a notch at the bottom of my panel. I placed the die on the bottom edge, right in the middle, and taped it to the paper, making sure that the arms of the die were up against the edge of the panel. Sent it to my die-cut machine, and I kept the remaining notch piece for later. Next, I cut two slots. The first one right above the notch, and to know exactly where to cut the second slot, I placed the basket with the bottom covering the first slot, and then I placed the slot die up against the top of the basket. Taped it to the paper and once again to the die cut machine. So here we have the two slots. To create the slider mechanism, I used a piece of plastic from my dog's poop bag. This can be very useful elsewhere than during work time. I cut a strip measuring a bit less than 1¼ inches wide and placed each end in a slot from the front of the panel. At the back, I applied a thin sticky tape on one end of the plastic strip. Removed the backing paper and then attached the other end of the plastic strip on that sticky tape. I cut off the excess of plastic and placed the seam at the very top. Off screen, I cut a pull tab that I colored using the same green inks as before. And next, I cut a piece of tape as large as the pull tab. I applied this small sticky piece on the plastic strip, right in the middle of the seam. I aligned the bottom edge of the tab with the notch and pressed down on the plastic strip to attach the pull tab to it. I tested the mechanism to see if it was working well, and then I trimmed off the tab. I set the panel aside for a little while and started to assemble the basket. And then the bunny, super easy and quick, and I only used liquid glue to do this. Next step was to finish the interactive part. I placed the basket and the bunny to get a general idea of the scene. And here you can see that the plastic strip was too low and the bunny couldn't reach it. Well, that's okay. I just used a piece of acetate to make it work. I applied sticky tape at one end of this acetate strip and attached it on the plastic strip right above the bottom slot. I also applied sticky tape at the back of the bunny. I placed the basket again on the panel, slided the bunny between the basket and the acetate, and pressed onto the bunny to stick it to the acetate strip. And then, to cover the mechanism, I finally attached the basket using foam squares on the sides only. And one last thing, I glued the bunny's paws to complete the basket. And then I stuck the sun, the clouds, and the butterfly in the top section of the panel using foam squares. Next, I added a few more flowers and leaves around the basket. And for my sentiment, I created the word bunny using a spring plate pattern paper along with guava letters to make the word pop on the pink cloudy background. I placed my panel in my Misty tool and stamped the words some and loves you using black ink. And then I attached the bunny letters to complete my sentiment that reads, "Some bunny loves you." And I used my tea ruler to glue the letters as straight as possible. Before attaching my panel to a card base, I needed to create a path at the back to make sure that the tab would stay straight. So I cut two thin strips of foam tape that I attached on both sides of the tab. Next, I applied more foam tape all over the back of the panel and stuck it on a slimline ballet slippers card base. I took the remaining notch piece from before and stamped "Pull here" on it and attached it at the very bottom of the pull tab. This way, the recipient of the cards knows what to do. And when I thought that the card was done, I felt like it was a little bit empty around the bunny. So I colored and attached three small butterflies and my card was finally complete. And that's it. I also added a few details and highlights using a white gel pen as well as white Nouveau drops. I hope that you like this bright and colorful spring little scene, and that you will get inspired to try this way of using the Let's Toast pull tab die set. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time. Have a good day. Bye.